Let's look at the Hall effect. We have a current carrying conductor. Let's say this is n-type semiconductor or a metal where electrons are the majority carriers. The current is flowing along this axis. We apply magnetic field. Now, because of this magnetic field, the electric field gets established in this, okay, which is known as Hall effect. Now, let's do some analysis. So, electrons are moving in this direction. Okay, we apply magnetic field. Because of this field, there is a force which is going to act on the electrons. So let's find out this force. Q is the charge of electron, Vd is the drift velocity, B is the magnetic field. So this product gives us this value, but Q is minus E. So this is the force acting on the electrons, which is in the negative y direction. So what happens because of this magnetic field, the electron starts moving in this direction and they start accumulating on this surface. Now, to maintain charge neutrality, equal and opposite charge builds up on this face, and because of this, the electric field gets established in the conductor. This is known as Hall effect. Now, this field also exerts force on the electrons. Okay, so the process of accumulation of electrons will go on until this force due to electric field will balance the force due to magnetic field. Okay, so this is the equilibrium equation, and if this is how we write this, and we get the expression for the drift velocity. Now, this is the way we define the current charge current density. If you replace this Vd by Ey by E and current density, we define this as the current flowing through this divided by the cross section area Wt. So if we simplify this further, I can write this Hall electric field as electric potential divided by this width W. So if you do this, then we get this, the charge density N is equal to BIVHED. So this is a very important expression, because if you see, all the quantities on the right hand side can be measured. So this gives us the charge density. Now this, we define Hall coefficient as 1 over NE, so which is equal to VHD over BI. And now we can use this Hall effect to find what kind of conductor we have, whether it's n-type or p-type. Is given by the sign of this Hall voltage. Okay, then we can also find out carrier concentration n, okay, in the given material. We can also find out the measurement of Hall coefficient, that is RH, and resistivity gives us the conductivity of the given material. And we can also use this as Hall probes, where since this VH is, if you pull all the terms on the right hand side, rest of the terms, then VH is proportional to B. So the Hall field is proportional to the magnetic field. So we can use you can also use this as a measurement of magnetic field.